Hey, Shalom Akim Shalom, Yabashmel Shai Brakatham. To my dear brothers out there, the Lenamana sisters that's watching and praying always, seeing that we are in the last days. All right. May the Heavenly Father be with you, brothers and sisters, man. And the final temptation, that Karagma, is coming upon us, and it's coming fast. And that's gonna be that test to show if you rather you believe in the creator of the heavens and the earth or not, or you believe in the doctrine that you hear the prophets, the Hebrew Israelites, you know, in particular Great Millstone, been talking about. It's fastly approaching, okay? Hey, but with that being said, though, let's give all praises to the creator of the heavens and the earth, the God of the Bible, Yahweh Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, Yahweh, that's the name of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Shai, that's the name of the beloved Son. And what you just heard me speak was the Paleo-Hebrew, okay? That's our language, and the Heavenly Father has returned it back onto us. All right, and we practice in it, and we call on the name of the Heavenly Father in our language again, not in English, not in no Greek, nothing. We call on Yahweh Shemal Shai in the Paleo Hebrew. His name is Yahweh, his son name is Yahweh Shai, and by those names, may you be delivered if your spirit is correct. Okay, so yeah, we're gonna do an open forum today. Double honor to the apostles of Great Millstone as well, because they taught us the true understanding of the scriptures. And hey, it was Apostle Tahar that the spirit jumped on to show what Revelation, the 13th chapter, when it talked about the M to the A to the R to the K, when it talks about that, Apostle Tahar brought that out. The spirit of the Lord showed him that. And then he had you know, just been around, been able to see the conversation of the apostle. It was trying to be said that he had got that from Alex Jones, you know, but no, he didn't get that from Alex Jones. Alex Jones, the Heavenly Father didn't put the spirit on Alex Jones to go into Book of Revelations and line it up. No, man, no. All right, these revelations are given to the prophets. Matter of fact, as it's written in Amos chapter 3, verse 7, it says, surely the Lord God will do nothing, but he revealeth his secrets unto his servants, the prophets. See? All right? So we have that. We have the true understanding of what the MOTB is. Okay? Now, what's recently been going on is that these devils are moving their money around. They're moving their money around, and they're getting things funded, and they're now activating these different fundings that they put their money into. Recently, Biden, see, we was talking about this at camp. Biden signed in March 9th, the executive order, I think it's 14067. He signed that in March. We're just now hearing about it. God freaking damn, you know what I mean? This is how this world works. They don't have a sense of care for the people, even though they call themselves being a part of a democracy, which means for the people, when you look up the word. They don't have a care for the people, though. It's all a facade and a lie. It's all smoke and mirrors. It's all semantics. So here it is. This guy signed the executive order, which allows the government to go in and out your bank account at will. So that means that these different banks is going to have agreements and things with contracts with each other, with the government on whoever is a part of their bank. And a lot of people want to find out when they go to the bank, there's going to be new sets of rules as time move on forward. So that executive order caused that, and it also caused the fact that you know what, I'm actually, what I want to say is that also, so that was signed, and that right there, see, to go in and out your bank account, you have to tie that to the what? You tie it to the Karagma. All right, what is the Karagma? It's the C-hip, okay? Put it together, put the C and the hip together, okay? To go in and out your bank account, that ties with that, all right? So these devils are making a lot of moves. Matter of fact, I grabbed this quick scripture. They're making a lot of moves using paperwork. And that's how this thing, this how the Heavenly Father is allowing this devil to feel like he's justified. on what he's doing to the world. It's Daniel chapter 8, verse 25. It says, and through his policy, also he shall cause craft to prosper in his hand. So through his policy, through his paperwork, that's how he's making these moves. He's causing craftiness, deceit, to prosper in his hand. All right, because I'm going to go into some recently he signed, but I'm giving you what the order of things that's been coming out. So he's also, Biden also funded $13.5 million to attack misinformation on the web. Anybody that's going against their agenda, basically, which is everything that encompassed the New World Order, all right? Also, the executive order that Biden signed, it also targeted misinformation in there. You know? Now, the new thing, you know what? Let me finish. It says, and he shall magnify himself in his heart, and by peace shall destroy many. See, it's by peace he's going to destroy many, because this next little news article that the brothers put up in the chat, now he's funded more money to further the agenda. He furthered more money, and it was a total of $52 billion. Biden signed to further more money in establishing the Kerygma. That's what it goes back to, period. It's going to be laws based around the Kerygma. That's what it is. And it's going to be made mandatory very soon. So, like the verse said, it said, and by peace he's going to destroy many. He's going to get a lot of you people to believe that his Kerygma is convenient for you. They're already doing it with your cars, your fucking, when you're walking in and out of a door, dude, just open the door. It's a couple seconds, but they're telling you about, they're using conveniency against you to trick you. We're going to get a verse on that, because he's going to deceive the people into taking this implementation. It says he also should stand up against the prince of princes, but he should be broken without him, because he's going to lose. At the end of the day, the Edomites are going to lose. This government is going to lose to the Lord Yahweh Shai and what the world calls the second coming. Now, let's go to that article that brother's been, his brother said this is all over CNN and everything, so it just lets you know if it's on the fluff news, you know, it's it has a hidden agenda. It's everything, you have to read between the lines. You have to be a very, you can't be, remember the scripture say, never trust thy enemy. You have to read it between the lines, because this devil, he be saying something in the forefront, but he means something totally different. Now it says, Biden signs order on $52 billion CHIPS law implementations. Now, I believe that when it says the CHIPS, I don't want to say the word because you get your video slashed. But it's just talking about an organization, because they had, every time I usually see it during the time of winter in the front of Walmart, they got actual organizations that's called CHIP. It's just the organization though. It's not talking about the actual, you know, grain of rice. All right. It's just an organization that's called CHIP with an S at the end. Now this organization, he signed $52 billion to helping these organizations with speeding up technologies, attacking how they've destroyed the economy. They did the destroying, but they're acting on like the solutions for it. So he's giving $52 billion in technologies to keep, and they're also saying to keep up with China, to help where the economy has been failing at, and to get these technologies spread throughout all of the states, man. So check it out. It says, and this is the picture of it. Look at this dude, man. You know, look at this picture, man. I don't know if you can see it. It's a little glare, but, you know. All right, these devils with their policies, like we read in Daniels. They cause craft to prosper in their hand. Now, let's read it a little bit. It says, U.S. President Joe Biden signs the CHIPS and Science Act of 2022, alongside Vice President Kamala Harris. So, here it is. You voted for this guy. This is your king that you voted for, all right? And now this is what you're getting. This is what you're getting from him. Now it says, I'm gonna jump down. It says, President Joe Biden on Thursday signed an executive order on implementation of $52.7 billion semiconductor chip manufacturing subsidy and research law, the White House said. Earlier this month, Biden signed the bill to boost efforts to make the United States more competitive with China's science and technology efforts. We know what's going on over there in China. And if you don't know, they established the social credit system over there. And then they're over there basically trying to be the forerunner for this technocracy that would be ran around the it was this technocracy, which meaning it'd be rule of technology, but it'll be ruled around the Karagma. That's what it'll be ruled around. You won't be able to go into this building unless you swiping. You know what I mean? You won't be able to purchase this unless you swiping. You know what I mean? So this $52 billion is going around to fund these different companies to be with the agenda, to be with it, to get the C-HIP activated. And you got to believe it's going to happen, because this is not about Esau Edom here. You hear Apostle Tahar say all the time, this is the Most High C-HIP. This is his karakma. He said that this will happen thousands of years before even taking place. So it said, earlier this month, Biden signs the bill to boost efforts to make the United States more competitive with China's science and technology efforts by subsidizing U.S. C-HIP manufacturing and expanding research funding. The law aims to alleviate a persistent shortage that have affected everyone from cars and weapons to washing machines to video games. Everybody's been affected because of, you know, this whole little since 2020 has took place. A lot of the middle class was wiped away. You know, if you didn't play your cards right, you lost your business. Well, now they're doing all this funding off of the damage that they have committed on everybody. They're doing all this funding now and got you people believing that they have the solution, but their solution is coming with the Karagma. That's what it's coming with. It's coming with the Karagma. The Karagma. The Karagma. You see it? I got it up on the screen. You know, for those who just out there, maybe just listening to the audio. The Karagma. The Karagma. You know? Man, great millstone. Hey, we report on this. We reporting on this. The only camp amongst the great millstone, I mean, the Israelites, you got Sakari that report on it, but, you know, that's here and there because he's too caught up in vain, you know, himself. You know, but he's also an offshoot of us anyway. So Revelation 3:3-10, it says, because thou hast kept the word of my patience, for all you brethren out there that's holding down the word to the best of your ability, striving for salvation, because you kept the word of my patience, I will also keep thee from the hour of temptation. What we've been talking about is the hour of temptation. Alright? It's gonna come to that point where you may get a little hungry, and now you're thinking about, oh shit, am I gonna lean on the Lord, or am I gonna go out there to one of these what would Esau call it? Detention centers and detention centers for safety, and go out there and get this thing put in me. You know, a lot of you women out there, it's gonna be hella challenging for you because you're the weaker vessel. A lot of these women, they got these houses with just children in them. No man. You know, when things get hard, it's gonna get hard. But the Lord said he's gonna keep us from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth. Now, everybody's finna experience this because the Lord said so. That's the reason why. Everybody's finna experience the C-hip, the karagma, because the Lord said so. It's a test on all the world. Now, tell me why over there in France, that little council they was holding, they said it's the end of December. Now get ready for the abundance of, what did they say? The abundance sliding me. Basically the abundance of of everything gone. Everything gone, you know? The shortage is at its max peaks. That's what the governor was saying. You enjoyed your summer, now get ready for this winter of abundance. I forgot what the word he used. He used abundance, and then there was another word like abundance shortage or something like that. Because around the world, I go to bring that point up, because around the world, this is gonna take place. These different economies are crashing themselves. Everybody's crashing themselves. Everybody have the word that they're moving. The whole entire planet, according to the Edomites, are moving into a new system. Out with the old, in with the new. Get with it, or be crushed by the damn beast. NATO, EU. That's what they pushing. That's what it is. So these economies, all of them is dealing with these shortages. All of them is dealing with these problems with their money, and it all finna get introduced with that karagma. Everybody. And the Lord said so. Okay? Now, we had talked about Revelation chapter 19, right? We had talked about how Esau is going to use deception. He's going to use deception. The self-proclaimed white man is going to use deception to get you to take this thing. You're going to have to, in your mind now, you have to understand what you're facing so you can be able to fight against it. He's going to use deception. He's going to use your hunger against you. He's going to use your thirst against you. He's going to use shelter against you. This is Revelation 19, verse 20. It says, and the beast was taken, and with him the false prophet, NATO and the EU. That's the beast. And America's a part of NATO. That's the beast, the Edomite government ship that's ruling the planet Earth. All right? It says, The beast was taken, and the false prophet, that's the Roman Catholic Church, because that's who they used to push forth this dogma of religion of Christianity on everybody. And it broke off into all your different denominations of Christianity. But they both gonna be taken. It says that wrought miracles before him, with which he deceived them that received the mark of the beast. The MOTB, he deceived them of taking an MOT. You see? So deception is gonna start tearing people apart into being destroyed. They're really gonna be thinking that there's no food. They're really gonna think that these things are naturally just taking place. They're not gonna know this is manufactured on their ass. They don't understand that. You know? So it says they were deceived into taking that thing. A lot of you Jakes, you're gonna get overtaken by how Esau is using natural disasters against you. Esau flooding your stuff and doing this and that, and you have no way of getting food, water, shelter. So then you're gonna be manipulating into going to get the C-hip. A lot of you see the food, they doing that on purpose. It's all type of videos that went out that they was destroying the food on purpose. They were destroying the different food plants. They took all the baby formula and they were just dumping it in the hill. You know, it was covering it with dirt. You know, There's mass amount of food pallets that's just chilling in the middle of nowhere. They remember those them ships that was off the coast, they just let all that food rot. You know? And remember, they got executive orders on the books that allow the government to seize all food. So the wherever they are putting the food at is for their troops or their foot soldiers to have nutrients while they take you over, man. So the deception is real. And that's the reason why we call the self-proclaimed white man the devil, because he is the devil, which means the deceiver. And he's doing that to you, man. And he's funding all these millions and trillions of dollars to this corporation, that corporation. Make this, make that for me. You know? And then another big thing that they do is they spend their money on is marketing. They gotta market it. When it's marketed right, now you created the fear in everybody. Because here it is, when March 2020 came, all you heard about was the pandemic on this part, this is happening, this is happening. Every time you turn the TV, every time you cut on the radio, every time you driving by a billboard, they market it so you could believe it. You know? They put it everywhere, all jamming in your face. If you didn't believe it at first, you're going to believe it later, because you're going to constantly be seeing the same thing over and over. And they're going to do the same thing with the Karagma. All right? Now, it says, and with which he deceived them that have received the MOTB and them that worshiped his image. And then you people going to think that this is good for you to, it said, worship his image. These people are going to bow to it, meaning that you're going to give in to the system. You're going to give in to that system. And you're going to be deceived. You're going to think that this is good. This Karagma is good. These people are going to get deceived. It says, and them that worship this image, these both were cast alive into the lake of fire burning with brimstone. You take that hot boy, you're going to get a hot, you're going to receive a hot boy. If you take that hot boy, you're going to get a hot boy. You know what I mean? Let me break that down for you. You take that Karagma, you're going to be destroyed in nuclear destruction. Revelation 14 and 9. These are the verses that, you know, and you know, we sound repetitive all the time, but I mean, damn. I mean, when you think about the scriptures, the Heavenly Father is very plain on what he's saying. You know? Certain portions of the scriptures, the Lord used similitudes of animals and things like that. And that's the reason why he gave you the prophets. But majority of everything is pretty simple for you, you know? And it's gonna put you in a decision. It's gonna put you in a place of you making a decision. What they call an ultimatum, you know? Or you're gonna get put in a quagmire. Or in other words, your back gonna be against the wall. You're gonna have to make a decision. That's what this is saying. So if you take this thing, Revelation 14 and 9 says, and the third angel followed them saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast in his image and receive his M to the A to the R to the K in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink the wine of the wrath of Yahweh Bashem Yahshai. So now what? Now what though? Here it is. The Lord said he gonna deal with you. You got a lot of people out there, well, should I just take it and just hope for the best with everything? Dude, the Lord said he gonna deal with you. Let me read it again for you. It says the same shall drink the wine of the wrath of the Heavenly Father. You have to deal with the Lord. And no, let me, if a brother may grab, it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands, you know, of the living power. If you may grab that, Baba Bouchard. You don't want to deal with the Heavenly Father, all right, in his anger. The Lord can bring upon you your most worst fears and then make you marinate in it. Make it feel like it's never ending. You know, that's what the Lord could do. He will do with you. And he is going to do with that with you, because it says, the saints shall drink the wine of the wrath of the Heavenly Father, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation. So then the Lord, he's similar, he's comparing it to how you gotta drink the nastiest part, meaning that you're gonna deal with his most fierce part of his anger. You know? The most fierce part of the Lord's anger. Alright? The kingdom within, Thwada Akia, Yabashmel Shai, Brakatari, bro. May the Lord put a blessing on you. Hebrews 10 and 31, it says, it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. Same likewise to the servant of the Most High, Yabashmel Shai, Brakatari, Most High, got a blessing on you as well, you know? Because, you know, hey, we aiding with each other, man. Hey, ain't nobody else doing this for us. Alright? Scripture talk about there's a few. Alright? But you're gonna fall, if you fall into the, it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God, man. And if you do so, you're gonna drink his most crucialest part, because mind you, Matthew's the 24th chapter, I believe the 21st verse, I could be mistaken, if your brother may want to grab that, but it goes, it's gonna be a day like never before. There's never a day to have occurred like this one that's coming. There's never gonna be a day like it after before. So it goes to show you that the Heavenly Father is finna tap into, as it said, the same should drink the wine of the wrath of the Most High, which is poured without mixture into the cup of his indignation. The Lord's finna tap into his torment to make you fear him. To scare you. Scared Straight, there was a show called Scared Straight. The Lord's getting ready to scare straight his creation. And there's in you know, the prophets, that we bring forth the good tidings, the gospel, meaning that there's a light at the end of the tunnel. Though you got to get correct, get right with the Lord, get right with the Heavenly Father, and you may have the possibility of being delivered from the karagma and all these things that's going to take place, because it's going to be a lot. All right. So did the brother grab that? Thwada Akim. Yep. Like the brother said, we don't want none of that smoke. Hell no, I don't want no smoke with the Lord, man. Hell no. All right. The servant of the Most High, Thwada Akim, Matthew 24 and 21, it says, for then shall be great tribulation, such as was not since the beginning of the world to this time, no, nor ever shall be. So the Most High is finna really show himself. You know, it's the Lord time to get off, to basically to step off his throne and lay the hammer down. You know what I mean? So it said back in Revelation 14 and 9, and I mean 8. No, I'm sorry. 14 and 10. It says, the saints shall drink the wine of the wrath of the Heavenly Father, which is poured out without mixture, into the cup of his indignation. And he shall be tormented with fire and brimstones in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. So the Lord said he's going to be tormented, meaning that you're going to be tortured, in other words. Nobody wants to be tortured. Come on, man. That word alone, if somebody told me they finna torture you, you automatically, oh, what you mean you're going to torture me? You know what I mean? The Lord's going to torture you in fire, though. That's going to be the nuclear destruction. But see, even before the nuclear destruction take place, because this is a system that's going to be established, some of you are going to take that karagma, and you're going to be going about your daily life until that day come where the missiles are coming. But before the missiles come, you're going about your daily life, the sun coming up and going down, you got the karagma in you, Esau's trying to take over the planet Earth. While that time is in its moment, you're not going to just be living some happy little for a second moment time. Oh, I got the karagma and I could just go back to the store, or I'm at this park, I could take my kids to the park and we could just do our thing. No, man. This whole world going to be in chaotic state, and you're going to be met with this portion of the MOT. This is Revelation 15 and let me see. No. Is this, yep, Revelation 16 and 2. It says, in the first went and poured out his vial upon the earth, and there fell a noisome and greasome sore upon the men which had the M-O to the T to the B, and upon them which worshipped his image. That karagma is gonna leave you with some type of grievous sore. Something's gonna be wrong with you, man. something's gonna be wrong with you. You're not gonna be the same. And these different, you know, whistleblowers, scientists and whatnot, right? They're telling you you're not gonna be the same after you taking this stuff. You drink the Kool-Aid, you're not gonna be the same. You take Haragma, you're not gonna be the same. We're warning you right now. You're hearing it from the prophets. The words of Yah Bashem Yah Shai from the prophets. You're not gonna be the same. You're not gonna just be going to the store or just doing what you want, waking up. No, you're gonna, this whole place is gonna be shut down. Second Exodus 15 and 16 goes all into the in-between moments before the missiles come. They're gonna be like madmen, sparing none. Matter of fact, I gotta grab it. Because a lot of people gonna take that Karagma, they're gonna be just dealing in the midst of all of this extra stuff that gotta come. And I'm gonna read straight through so you can just hear it, man. People think they're gonna just be good. I got it and I'm just back at home. And tomorrow I'm gonna wake up and take my ass to Krispy Kreme donuts, give me one of them fire donuts, and then I'm going to work after that. Man, ain't gonna be like that. Ain't gonna be no work for Egypt. Ain't gonna be no just going down the street. Executive orders are gonna be full blast and in motion. All property, all food, all shelter, all communications, all transportation will be owned by the government and regulated. This is 2nd Exodus chapter 16, verse 2nd Exodus chapter 15, verse 16. It says, and there should be sedition among men and invading one another. They should not regard their kings nor princes in the course of their actions to stand in their power. You're going to have people out here that just renegades to the government, to the United States or wherever they at. They're going to be renegades. Sedition means an uprising of the people. So you're going to be in the midst of people just killing each other for food and water. It says a man should desire to go into a city and should not be able. You're not going to be able to go to your next city over. You know, you're not going to just be walking like people walking in this park right now. Everything going to be barricaded off. Everything's going to be quarantined off and they're going to be turned into zones. There's the FEMA region zones. And the Lord is allowing this, yo. Because it's time for judgment now. You didn't have your run of wickedness. Now it's time to meet all those wicked acts that you didn't did in the earth. Now it's time to meet and speak up on them. And you ain't gonna have nothing to say. It's just gonna be a divine ass whooping for you. Just straight to your face, man. You know? It says, families are going to be split up. Dad going to probably be in the next city. Mom going to be in the next city and the children at home. It's going to be all type of terribleness going on. People krogmed up. Whatever the juice is going to do to the people. And people with this sea hit stuck in a concentration camp. Concentration is the game. Keep the... Remember that? the spirit just had me think of that. Concentration. You're gonna be straight into concentration. You know? It says, for because of their pride, the city shall be troubled, houses shall be destroyed, and men should be afraid. It says, a man shall have no pity upon his neighbor, but shall destroy their houses with the sword and spoil their goods because of the lack of bread and for great tribulation. So this is what's all gonna be going down while people are at the same time getting karagmed up. You know, and Esau gonna be using this karagma for like the solution to end all this chaos. And he had the famous Latin saying, order out of chaos. So these people that take this thing, they have a rude awakening of a life turned upside down season. I'm talking about your shit's turned so upside down that he's shaking you, your chains fall out, even your lint coming out your pocket. The Lord gonna shake you upside down, make the lint come out your pocket, man. With all type of you know, just judgments. All right, so jumping back to Revelations though, that 14th verse, because it says something that's key. You're gonna be ashamed of what you did if you take that thing. You're gonna be ashamed because the verse said, it said, and he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. Whoever the elect are, the ones who do that which is right, and they're gonna get beamed up, they're gonna watch you be burned. The angels of the angelic forces gonna watch you be burned. And the Heavenly Father, Son, Yahweh Shai, gonna watch you be burned. So then at that moment, the ones that's in the chariots being saved, they're gonna think to themselves, all praise Yahweh Shemel Shai that I listened. I listened to the prophets, I listened. Now, we in August right now, August 20, 2022, you remember you listened. So now that's why you in that chariot, man. And then the people down here that took the Kerygma and just didn't do that which is right in the sight of the Lord, they're gonna be looking up, wishing they listened. This is all moments that's gonna come to truth. This is gonna take place in the Heavenly Father's timeline. It says, in their smoke and their torment ascended up forever, and they had no rest day nor night, who worshiped the beast in his image, and whoever received the M to the A to the R to the K of his name. And the Lord ain't gonna allow you to rest. There's no rest for you, man. Like we were saying, there's no rest. You take that thing, it's no rest for you. All right? We went into how that Kerygma, it can manipulate you, man. Your lob, the Hebrew word for the heart is lob. It's gonna manipulate your lob. Okay? Take it over. Using low frequency wave. All right? You know how deadly low frequency waves are? Esau, I tell you. Even at that dude who died, I don't know nothing about him, but I seen a little video of his name XXX Extension or some shit like that. But the dude was talking about how he's mastering in frequencies, and he can manipulate the music to do whatever he wants it to do to affect his fans or whoever listens to it. If he wants to put you to sleep, he can put you to sleep by putting frequencies in the back. If he wants you to be hyped and get up, he'll put the frequencies in the back of the track. If he's doing that with music, this Edomite is doing that with the Kerygma. And you will be that. You will be the receiver, or you will be that antenna for them towers he building around. So you ain't gonna have no rest day or night. If you take that thing, you're not gonna be good. You know, ain't gonna be gravy. You just got in, you good. So don't listen to General Yohanna. Don't listen to General Yohanna. Don't listen to any man that's telling you to get that thing. Get right with Yahweh Shemel Shai. Correct your spirit, and the Lord will fight for you. Strive on to the truth to the death, and the Lord will fight for you. That's what's going. That's what you need. All of us are aiming with. Because, like we start the lesson off, they're funding millions and billions of dollars to get this stuff going. In December 13th, at that point, they're talking about no more cash. I went into it in my last little news, madness, and encouragement lesson I just did a couple hours ago. Starbucks and these different fast food chains, they're getting ready. Starting October 1st, they're not receiving no more cash. They're only taking cards and reward payments. This thing is in motion. We're going to watch it as it unfolds, and we're going to continue to stay in order with Yahweh Shemel Shai to the best of our ability, in all hopes that the Lord have mercy on us, man. You know, we're doing that which is right. And we ain't going to be ashamed, Lord willing. Yahweh Shemel Shai will, whoever the elect are, they're not going to be ashamed to stick to this word and to the truth. When Esau got you tied up, trying to put that in your face, take this or take that, what you want. You going to take this or you going to take that, what you want. Or however it may go about, The elect ain't gonna be ashamed. They gonna say, shove that goddamn crogma up your ass. For all we give a damn, put that motherfucker in your ear, you bastard. The God of the heavens and the earth is with me, man. That's what we banking on, man. And let the Lord take over from there, man. But it requires building your mind up now. Because we ain't do nothing as far as choosing evil. We're not going to choose evil. So the Heavenly Father ain't going to be mad at us, man. He ain't going to be mad at us. He's going to be mad at Esau for doing that to us. And he going to have to pay, you damn devils. So, hey, through the spirit and power of Yahweh Shemel Shai, the water for you, Akim, passing by, man. Just wanted to talk about that real quick. It's been a lot of funding, a lot of money getting pushed out. And this agenda and this karagma is showing itself. So we're going to continue to, you know, do that which is right in the sight of the Lord. And to the next time, hey, Yahweh Shemel Shai, Barakatam to all you brethren. Shalom.